Alright folks, welcome to the webinar. It is Thursday, June 20th, and we are looking at the SPX and you're looking at the custom indicators for intraday trading of the SPX itself. When I say SPX, you can also do the ES, you can do the options on ES, you can do the SPY, you can do the mini ES futures that has just been released by CBOE. You can do any of this, but if you do the spiders, just be aware it's just like a stock, so it is assignable if you do get into a credit spread situation which is in the money. So other than that, you can use any of these instruments to trade. All right, so we are coming on the heels of yesterday's FOMC announcement, which seemed to indicate that the rate cut is coming, and so markets are jubilant today. Yesterday also it went up slightly, not a whole lot. So today's reaction is a little surprising to me that such a reaction did not happen yesterday. Well, yesterday it was negative and then it climbed positive to about 8 points or so, but not a whole lot. But today's action is pretty intense. So what we are looking at here is two indicators. We got the tick SPX, which is a measure of the tick itself. So now here I need to change this to on the study, because the dollar tick is a Dow Jones, Dow Jones study, and what we want is the tick SPX. So on this indicator itself, you have the ability to customize all of this stuff. There are various ticks available in the market. I'm going to choose tick SP. Okay, apply. Okay. So now we are looking at the tick SP here, and I'm just going to save this tick SPX, so I don't have to do this every day. So the tick is a measure. So out of the 500 S&P stocks, each stock ticks up or down all the time at a microsecond level. And so at any given time, the tick is calculated in a cumulative sense. And so if we go back to yesterday's, and this is a 1 day, 1 minute. Yeah, let's go back to yesterday's trading action here. And I'll just show you what happened during the trading hours. Obviously, this indicator only works when the markets are open. Okay, so not in the pre-market, not in the aftermarket. So yesterday, you can see. So what happens is, there's some pent-up demand that comes in, and then finally, the tick started moving up a little bit, but then it lost ground, and then it went negative up until the 2 p.m. hour Eastern time, and that's when the tick started going positive, and you can see this is the 2 p.m. hour, and then the FOMC announcement comes, and from then on, the tick goes, the tick never really crosses zero, and that's really surprising to me, but obviously it was on an up trend all the way into the close. And so this is a cumulative calculation. So all the ticks that have happened before it and all the ticks that are currently happening, it gets added. And so it gives you a true sense of the market internal, the strength of the market internals. And that's really extremely important, because when you're day trading, in a stock, you don't have this kind of information. But with the SPX, you do. And so you want to take advantage of this deep internal market data that's available. And so the best way to do that would be to make a cumulative total and have that as a running total there. So that's the tick. And once we start here, you will see the tick starting to develop. And then we want to, now this is a 1 minute chart. So you want to wait for at least, 5 to 7 minutes to see what's going on. Unless there's, huge momentum coming in and it's very clear that markets are going up, then you might want to take a trade in at the open itself. But in general, there can be some fake outs at the open. And so you want to be careful of that. You also want to also just let the market settle in, because there is pent up demand, right now coming in from the pre-markets, especially with the futures up about 28 points. There's going to be some pretty heavy movements. Already you can see it went up to 29.64. Now it's come down to 29.61 here. And so the RSI is also a custom indicator, as opposed to a regular RSI, which tells you when something is overbought or oversold. This indicator has also been customized to the point where when it enters what I call this as a bullish zone and a bearish zone, it actually means that you can stay in the trade for this long. So over here, you can start trading as it goes up itself and based on the ticks as well. The RSI is only a confirmation indicator. It is not a primary indicator. So you do want to watch the ticks for the primary indicator, but the RSI can provide, this custom RSI can provide some pretty serious confirmation. And so that's what we'll be looking at, both of these indicators after the markets open. We'll do that and then let's see how it goes. So right now there's a little bit of a pullback. I'm not surprised. I think it's a fake out. The markets want to go up for sure. So basically we'll be looking at call trades. Now if you look at the option chain itself, now these are, you know, very day trades, and so we can even go to this today's expiry. And my sense is that when you use these kinds of indicators and trade, you're getting a pretty reliable signal. So if something falters in that, then you're better off just closing the trade for a small loss. So in general, I would say your reward to risk on any trade is going to be about 3:1. And so if you need to just lose one trade, that's okay, because you're going to make a lot more on the winners than you lose on the losers. And so that's really what we are going to be trying to do. And therefore, even though this expires today, no worries, you can still go into this. Now these option prices, you can see now, SPX is going to open around 2960 something, okay? So here we are 2930, this call is deep in the money, and that's why you see option price like this. Whereas on the put side, you 2930 put, those option prices here, but so what I'm saying is the line that separates in the money and out of the money is not correct, and that will only adjust after the markets open. So here we are looking at, and at the money is somewhere here, somewhere here, maybe 2955 to 2960, somewhere there is really the at the money. And so today, if we wanted to take a trade on the SPX on the call side, what I would say is somewhere near the 2965, that would be approximately a 20 delta, but these deltas are going to change. So let's just watch the market and see where it goes. All these things is going to adjust now. Okay, 2952, that's where it is. So I would say if we want to go, we would go to a 30 delta right there. Okay, and let's just watch the ticks come in. I'm just keeping the call option ready so that we can get in when we want to. All right, you can see that this is moving. Ticks are moving. It started out at 150, but let's just give it a little time here. Make sure there's no fake out. In fact, the fake out should be to the upside given this little pullback here. So in that sense, we may be okay, but let's just give it a minute or two and let these ticks also develop. As you can see, the RSI is coming from a bearish zone based on this price action right here. So let's just watch it. That was the first minute. I'm going to zoom in a little bit here so we can see clearly. So the second tick is opening at 267. So what it means is the number of upticks minus the number of downticks is 271. So this number actually doesn't mean anything, because the tick level can go to anything. It can go to 1000, it can go to 1500, it can go to any value. So there's no real intrinsic information there, except if the ticks are going positive, then it's a bullish thing. If the ticks are going negative, it's bearish. And the magnitude of the positive and the magnitude of the negative is what we are going to be looking at. All right, those are some swing trades that I've done. So you can leave that alone. All right, looks like a downtick there, but you can see pent up demand is still driving the ticks higher. So there is pent up demand, and that is driving the ticks higher. But what we will want to see is just wait for a couple of bars. This is exactly why we need to wait for a couple of bars to do this. And once we get the confirmation that it's looking to go higher, because on a day like this, it would definitely be looking to go higher. All right, now you can see some ticks coming down. But once again, I really think this is a fake out, and the fake out can last anywhere from 5 minutes to 10 minutes. It's actually going to give us a better entry, for this trade, because ultimately, I don't think the futures will drive up. I don't think the futures will drive up to 25 and 29 points if the big players want to take it down all the way from there. They're just taking it down so they can get a better entry point here. All right, definitely looking a little bearish the first the first few minutes after the open, but we are just in our fifth bar here. So if there was a fake out, then it'll be coming out sometime soon. In the next minute or so, we should see the market start. You just saw that a big huge volume burst that went into it. Yeah, there you go. So let's see if this has any change, but we would need to see. Yeah, the ticks have moved up. We would need to see an uptick on the RSI as well. That would be a good confirmation. So on a day like this, we are coming in with a bias. We are coming in with a bias that the markets are going to go up, because I mean it's up 30 points in the pre-market. So that is an obvious bias that I think anybody will have. And therefore, while we could have said that, oh, you can take a put trade on this, but that's really you wouldn't want to do that. Okay, the ticks dropped to 179. All right, let's just wait. But the thing can happen anytime, though. I mean, the turnaround will be quite vicious here. If we see a sudden burst to the upside, that's really when you want to get in. So I think at this point, if we were to go in, we can go in on the 2960 also. So I'm going to put 2960 here. So I've got the today's expiry. Okay. So 2960 call. I'm getting that ready. All right. Now you can see something happening. RSI is moving higher. There we go. That burst seems to be coming. Let's see. We would want to wait. I'm just getting this ready. Okay. I'm just getting this ready. So this is going for between 480 and 5. So, all right, the ticks are moving up, the RSI is moving up, okay? So, if this bar, if we can see some improvement, especially in the RSI and in the ticks also after this bar, I think you can see the option prices are also moving higher. And you can see this is like a bottoming out pattern. When you have a cup-like formation, that is a bottoming out pattern, but it's fully not developed yet, so I'm just waiting. It's okay to get a slightly later entry. Might pay 10-20 cents more for the option, but now you can see it's charging higher, guys. Okay, 480, there we go, 490. You can see the option price also moving. I'm going in 490. Okay, we are in at 490 on this. Now let's just watch this here. All right, so SPX position right now, it's just about flat. RSI, you can see, and whenever the RSI crosses this, you'll get an arrow from the indicator also. So that tells you. Now you can see the ticks are moving higher, the RSI is also moving higher. Now you can see some persistent ticks coming into the upside. You've got about 4 or 5 here now. All right, looking pretty good. Ticks are moving up, 352, and also the RSI. What would really be comforting is if the RSI goes into the bullish zone. Okay, so that would be very good. But as of now, let's just see what this is. There we go. We are up 125. Well, these are my custom indicators. Question is, you don't use too many indicators, just RSI and tick SPX. Yeah. So these are custom indicators, and so you really if you have the faith in these, then you don't need anything else. I can put some moving averages, this, that, and there's no harm with that, obviously. But you don't want to get into too many indicators also. You don't want to get paralyzed by too many things going on. All right, couple of weak ticks there, but you don't want to get shaken out of it, because you want to keep the number of ticks to, because this is a 1 minute chart, so you want to keep it at least 5 to 7 bars before you get shaken out. Once you, if you move it to a 5 minute chart, yeah, 2 bars is good, but we are looking at a 1 minute chart here, so we do need to give that. But the ticks are still positive, which is above the zero. It's 136, just it's been coming down a little bit. So let's see. And as I said, you don't want to let this thing run too much, and so does not want to go up too much, then we'll just get out of the trade. That's better than trying to do anything with the trade, like trying to adjust it and things like that. So, all right, there comes a nice big push. There we go. You can see the volume also just coming in nicely. There we go. That's the kind of push I was looking for earlier, but I think it's coming in here now. You can always, on the 1 minute chart, it's actually quite interesting because you can see the volume bars just jump with a huge move, whether it's to the upside or downside. You can actually see the big volume jump happening there. So it gives you a good clue there. All right, RSI is moving towards the bullish zone, which is encouraging. Moving up now, it's gone into the bullish zone. So once it goes into the bullish zone, what we want to do is see if it can stay there, or rather, as long as it stays there, that's telling you to stay in the trade. Let's just see. Okay, $300, not too bad. Question, would you be doing a trade tomorrow with a stop on the new indicator? This indicator works only on the indices. That's it. It doesn't work on any stock. You could try to use the indicator to trade on a correlated, highly correlated stock, but that's also you're taking a, it's not a risk, but you know, you're taking a small chance because that particular day, the stock might not correlate very well. All right, you can see a little bit of a downtick and also the RSI is slowly just dipping in there, but that's not enough. You don't want to get shaken out. Now, when I say hang in there for 5-6 bars, that is a general guideline. But when we have a profit, you know, then, you know, if the profit is pretty good, you can at least peel off some of this, maybe 3 out of the 5 contracts. I don't think we are at that stage yet. It's still looking pretty bullish. So we'll just let it hang in there for some more time and let's see how it goes. Yeah, it's moving up nicely. And now you can see the RSI moving into the bullish zone nicely. The tick calculation just went, well, let's see what the latest tick is. I think it's gone over 400 for the last bar here. Went over 400, yeah, 457. And now it is 545. So the ticks are improving. And as you can see, it's going well. My philosophy is, okay, you know, these are day trades, things can change. And so, you know, I would, if it's things are moving in your way, I would periodically try to just peel off some, not a whole thing, let the trade run. But here we go, it's moving even higher now. So I'll just peel off one contract actually. And because it's looking good. The RSI also is telling us that, okay, we are in the bullish zone right now and the ticks are moving higher. So let me see where we are. It's not executing. Okay, we should get executed. We put it at 6. All right, there we go. Sold one. You can trade. Oh, question is, what are the index you can trade with this tick? You can trade any of the indices. So the Dow Jones, the Russell, Nasdaq, as well as the S&P. So my view on that is that the S&P gives you the broadest picture of the US markets and US companies in general. It's the 500 largest US companies. The Dow Jones just gives you a snapshot of 30. I mean, the index is calculated based on 30 stocks. The Russell goes to 2000, but those 2000 are very small stocks. So they are the real small cap of the US markets. The Nasdaq is a highly concentrated a set of stocks between technology and biotech. So as you can see, they're not a broad reflection of the market like the S&P is, and that's why I like the S&P the most. I thought maybe on this, after these two bars, there might be a lower tick, but no, the tick has gone up to 642 now. But I think it'll come down on this bar. Okay, we have a profit of about 490, 500 is coming down in a hurry. So I would want to take two off. This is strictly from a profit management standpoint, because when you have a nice profit, you don't want to leave it. Okay, so I took two contracts off, so which means that we are left with two. Total profit is about $480 on this trade, and open is 170, so we have booked about $350, somewhere close to that already. You can see the ticks are coming down, and you can see the RSI also dipping, but let's wait for this bar and then we'll take the call on this trade. Because at some point these trades will run out of momentum. So, no, this you can trade at any time with the index. Okay, I mean you can trade all through the day. I trade only at the open. This is my service that I provide. I trade only at the open. I mean, you know, it's not possible to give this commentary and manage the software and do all of that and do the analysis and talk and everything for all day. So I picked my 1 hour, and that 1 hour is best at the market open. So just like we saw a bottoming out pattern here, this is a potential topping out pattern, still not developed fully. And you can see the RSI just dipped below the bullish. I'm getting out. 460 or whatever it is perfectly fine, because you can always get in, right? I mean, the only cost is the commission, and for 5 contracts, your commission will be maybe $7 or $8. So, whereas even 2 ticks down will you lose $50 in that. All right, $510 on this trade, folks. $510. Okay, you can see some ticks coming in, and I did not exit. By the way, let me explain my philosophy. I did not exit because I saw these 2 or 3 bars. I exited because I have a good profit and I don't want to give it up. Okay, so that's the principle behind exiting this trade. It's like, you know, the profit is there. Why do you want to give it up? Because I said, right, don't get shaken out by 3 or 4 or 5 bars. But when you have a profit, take it. You can always enter again.
So if you want a free trial of this day trading signal service, you can go to this bit.ly link. It's bit.ly /day-signals. Now the day and the D and the S has to be capitals. And once you go there, you can get a free trial. You'll need to sign up there and you'll get a free trial. And at the end of 1 week, if you don't want to continue, you can just send us an email at info@optiontiger.com and we'll give you a full refund. So once again, the bit.ly link is bit.ly /day-signals with the DNS in caps. Thank you.